Hello everyone, I'm Zach Marr. I'm a student doing a directed study here at Kennesaw State University under Dr. Ayse, Tekes. My partners Kevin Vanderhorn and Chong, Tian and myself are here trying to solve a problem, and that is, how can we simplify the laboratory systems used to teach vibrations and control systems information to students? So here we have an example of a rectilinear mass slider system. We have springs, masses, and dampers. This system is machined using metallic parts, and it's fairly expensive, it's pretty heavy, and students can't use it personally. The goal with our project was to simplify this system into a format that's easier to use, cheaper, and more accessible to students.
Here is our dual parallel arm mechanism. It is made of mice and beam. The beam is made of PLA and PEG. PEG is more flexible, but it is expensive. PLA is cheap and easy to work with, and you can easily change the configuration by changing the number of beam attached to it. And here comes to Kevin with his experiment.
So over here we have our complete experimental setup. Right now we have six links attached in a parallel configuration with our sliding mass that only moves in the X direction. Attached to the top of it we have our triaxial 3D accelerometer fed using a PCB system into the signal expressed by LabVIEW software. And when you perform the experiment, what you need to do is you displace the mass as initial distance, you let go, and you allow it to vibrate and oscillate. The top graph you can see we record acceleration versus time data, and the bottom graph we record amplitude versus frequency data. This frequency graph can be used to determine the natural frequency of the system, and by applying logarithmic decrement to the acceleration versus time graph, you can determine the damping coefficient C of the system, which cannot be measured directly. And because these are six links in parallel, you can calculate the K equivalent by just multiplying 6 times the K value of each spring.